Никто из нас не застрахован от того, что в наш дом заползет таракан. Фу, ну или в форточку залетит муха. Все мы знаем, что от мух отлично помогает мухобойка, а от тараканов – тапка. Но что делать, если таракан окажется слишком велик, а муха не в меру агрессивна? Ну а в этом случае я рекомендую пистолет.
The British government getting very upset about what's happening to Alexei Navalny in Russia. He's just been put in prison. And the Daily Mail here saying thousands of Russians post selfies wearing red tops to show support of jailed opposition leader Alexei Navalny's wife. As they repeat his words, don't be sad, everything will be fine. Well, that's okay, everything will be fine. Except that Russia Today had an article a couple of days ago which said this: the top Navalny aide asked alleged British spy for millions in funding, intelligence video released by Russian's FSB claims to reveal. Now, this is very interesting because there is a video clip on that article, which apparently shows Navalny's aide meeting with this gentleman, James Ford, who describes himself on his Twitter feed as a British diplomat in Brussels, European foreign policy, Russia, Turkey, Balkans, Middle East, previously in Moscow, Paris, Ankara, English-Swedish family is how he describes himself on Twitter. But this really has to be seen in the context of the recent document drops that have appeared via Anonymous, which is showing exactly this type of operation funded through the Foreign Office Conflict Security Stability Fund and so on, right? But the RT article saying that they believe, or the FSB believes that Ford is an MI6 agent. They've given no proof of that. There's very little on the internet that can be shown that he is, but he is or was a member of the British delegation at the annual UK-Russia Human Rights Dialogue. It was led by the Foreign and Commonwealth Office's Eastern Europe and Central Asia Director Colin Roberts, Colin Roberts, I believe, is MI6. So it's very, very hard to know exactly whether Ford is British intelligence. Certainly, British Foreign Office involvement in providing money to Navalny seems to be indicated by this video clip. And again, we've got British money going into opposition campaigns around the world. We've got to be asking our government what they're up to.
If we had more money, we would expand our activities, of course. With a little money, if somebody would spend, I don't know, $10-20 million a year on supporting this, we would see quite different picture. And this is, not a big amount of money for people who have billions at stake in this game.
Yeah.
So that's the message that I'm trying to project in my fundraising efforts and talking to people, business community, and so on. We release a report of VTB Bank in association with the Henry Jackson Society in London, which paints the picture of how VTB.
Here, a short pause for the waitress. You never know. She could be a spy trying to listen in.
How VTB is involved in corruption, how risk management is not working, and we make the case that it represents the threat to European financial markets and to their integrity because it's a significant player in Europe and they make it more difficult for British firms like Lloyds or RBS or other big banks to Barclays to compete.
Of course, the Navalny camp's going to say, no, this is just Russian disinformation. They've set it up. It's not real. I don't know. Do we still have that Navalny video?
Oh, we do indeed, yes.
Well, this is interesting. You have got that ready to
yes,
go?
Yes, ready to
okay.
go.
Okay, let me just get this straight, okay? Alexei Navalny is sort of branded as the democratic opposition in Russia, the hero, he's feted by the West, the, quote, opposition leader in Russia. He's not the leading opposition in Russia. I would say actually the Communist Party is probably in second place right now in the Russian Federation. But nonetheless, he's loved on CNN. He's loved in the West. And so who is Alexei Navalny? What are his politics? Is he a woke liberal reformer?
Well, he must be because we're giving him money, surely.
But in fact, what is he really? He is regarded in Russia as far-right, xenophobic, and by many people, a sort of a proto-fascist, okay? And this is completely lost by the Western media. Nobody's talking about this. Let's roll this video. This is Alexei Navalny putting out his anti-immigration campaigning. But watch this and look closely.
Здравствуйте! Сегодня мы поговорим о борьбе с насекомыми. Никто из нас не застрахован от того, что в наш дом заползет таракан. Фу! Ну или в форточку залетит муха. Все мы знаем, что от мух отлично помогает мухобойка, а от тараканов – тапка. Но что делать, если таракан окажется слишком велик, а муха не в меру агрессивна? Ну а в этом случае я рекомендую пистолет.
Right.
He's so woke, isn't he?
Yes.
He's so woke. That's what you call a far-right white supremacist, white nationalist. The real thing, actually. And that's who...
And that's who the West is promoting, and the British government, the US government are promoting as hard as they possibly can at the moment.
That's exactly who they're pushing and promoting.
So if Navalny did succeed in ousting Putin, which isn't going to happen, but if he did, what kind of Russia would that become?
It would become a lot more scary in many ways, probably from a human rights point of view, a lot more brutal. So this they've been constantly doing this, trying to package Vladimir Putin as this kind of, you know, next version of Hitler, et cetera, is giving him the Hitler treatment. Vladimir Putin is a moderate in comparison to someone like Alexei Navalny, which is precisely why Navalny will never have a mandate in Russia. He'll never be elected to anything in Russia. He just doesn't have broad appeal. I mean, people in Russia know about those types of adverts.